Hello, welcome to another edition of TutorTube, where Learning Center's lead tutors help you understand challenging course concepts with easy-to-understand videos. My name is Kelly Schmidt, lead tutor for statistics at the Learning Center. In today's video, we'll go through the process of finding the sum of squares, standard deviation, and variance of a dataset using hand calculations with some assistance from Excel. If you've never used Excel and are brand new to statistics, this video is for you. So let's get started. Before we jump into calculating these values, let me give you some idea of the general idea behind what we're trying to do when we find the sum of squares, the variance, and the standard deviation. So let's say we have a set of numbers which represent test scores on an English test for a certain class of 8 high school students. We can find the average score by adding up the numbers and then dividing by the number of students, and this gives us 75. So we can say that the average score on this test was a 75%. However, the average value only tells us about one aspect of this class of students. We know overall that the class had a C average on the test, but that number alone doesn't give us any information about how spread out the scores were. So for example, let's say we had another class of high schoolers taking the same test and they got the scores shown here. If we take the average, we get the same value, 75. But this class, if we look at the scores themselves, they look a lot different. The first class had scores that ranged between 45 to 98, whereas this class had scores ranging from 0 to 100. In order to get an idea of the spread of these two groups, we need another type of statistic. This is where the idea of sum of squares, variance, and standard deviation comes into play. For a sample, the formulas for each are shown here. Notice how similar each of the formulas are. In fact, we'll use the sum of squares to calculate the variance, and then use the variance to calculate the standard deviation. Also, remember that these formulas we use when dealing with samples. If we're working with a population, the formulas would change just a little bit. And if you've never worked with this kind of mathematical notation before, don't worry about it. I'll walk through the process of finding them step by step. Start by opening up a blank sheet and then entering in the data for the first class of students. First, we need to find the mean of the scores. So click into a blank cell anywhere on the sheet and then type equals average parentheses. Next, click and drag to select all the values in our class, and then type a close parentheses, hit enter. This will spit out the mean, or the average value, of our dataset, which we know should be equal to 75. Okay, now we make a new column, which I'll call score minus mean. In this step, we want to build out the middle part of our complicated sum of squares formula by taking each person's score and subtracting the overall mean. The idea is that we want to find the distance of each score from the average score of the group, which was 75. So in the second box, type an equal sign, and then click on the box holding your first score, 45. Next, type a minus sign, then type in your mean of 75, and hit enter. Excel took the score of 45 and subtracted the mean of 75 to give us a value of negative 30. We could repeat this for each of our observations down the column, but Excel has a shortcut. Click on the cell with the negative 30 inside, and then put your cursor over the little black box at the bottom right, and when you see it turn into a black plus sign, click and drag down the column. This copies the formula into each of the cells. Now that we have our full column of scores, we need to square each of them. I'll make a new column called score minus mean squared. Just like we did before, we click into the first cell and type an equal sign, then click on the cell to the left, which now contains our negative 30. This time, instead of subtracting 75, we want to square this value, so we type a caret and hit enter. Negative 30 squared gives us 900. Now we drag the cell down to apply the formula to the full column. In the next step, we need to sum up all of these values. Again, we could do this by hand by just adding them up, but Excel has a shortcut function. So click on an empty cell anywhere and type equals sum parentheses. Then click and drag along the column of values we just calculated, type close parentheses, and hit enter. This tells us that the sum of all the numbers in the column is 1868, and this value is our sum of squares, SS. If we want to find our sample variance, we divide our sum of squares by n minus 1, which is sample size minus 1. Our sample size here is 8 because we had 8 students in this class. So we need to divide 1868 by 7. To do this in Excel, choose any empty cell and type equals 1868 divided by 7, hit enter, and our sample variance is roughly 266.86. Finally, we can calculate the standard deviation for this sample. To do this, we just need to take the square root of our variance. So choose any empty cell in Excel and type equals sqrt parentheses. Then click on the cell containing the variance value of 266.86 that we just calculated and type close parentheses. Hit enter. And we have our value of 16.34 for our standard deviation. And that is all there is to it. We found our value for sum of squares, variance, and standard deviation. If you want to check your work, you can also use Excel's shortcut formula to get the standard deviation in one step. We can type equals STDEV dot S parentheses in an empty cell and then highlight our original list of values, close parentheses, and enter. This should be exactly the same value that we got by building out our step-by-step formula by hand. Since it matches, we know that we did all of our steps correctly. So thank you for watching this TutorTube presentation. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our channel for more exciting videos, check out the links in the description below for more information about the Learning Center, and follow us on social media. See you next time.